Welcome to our weekly KGTR Guitar Hero Anonymous meeting. I'm Jason, one of your group leaders.
And I'm Ben. Well, we have a new member attending today, so we'd like everyone to go around and introduce themselves.
Hi, I'm Jolie P.
I'm Josh L.
I'm Crispy Man.
Hi, I'm Logan D, and I'm addicted to Guitar Hero.
Hi, Logan.
In the video, member Christopher shows us what brings people like us together and tears us apart. Let's see what he had to say.
Language. It's one thing that seems to separate us as teenagers. The different forms of English often create tension between us all. We investigated to find out what exactly is behind this mystical force.
I don't think I would accept a friend if they didn't speak like I did, because it just doesn't, it's not like the same person. Like, they don't have the same personality that I do.
It matches your personality.
Yeah, for sure. Like, I couldn't hang out with someone that didn't talk like I did, because I wouldn't, like, understand them.
Depends on who they are. I mean, if they're just one of those weird, you know, people you don't like, you know? No, but if they're just, I guess, art to hang out with, and why not, you know?
Accept everybody. Everybody my brother. And as you can see, look at this togetherness right here.
Most of my friends talk the same way that I do.
Sort of.
I mean, like, I have some friends that don't talk like I do.
Yeah, some of my friends are different, but it's like, sort of the same.
No, not really. I mean, hang out whoever you want to. No.
Sometimes, like, different country people, like me, like, they have a different accent, so sometimes I can understand, so I can ask, say it again or something.
No, nobody really speaks like my friends speak at all. Pretty unique thing. They have trouble understanding me.
To me, homeboy, Nasty me, friend, you know, Nasty could be anything. We could be like, he could be all the way over there, you know what I'm saying? We say, I'd be like, what's up, Nasty? Oh, nothing nasty. We're just chilling, Nasty.
My friends, you know, I like to speak Spanish with them, you know, so some of the people, when I'm trying to communicate with somebody and I want them to know what I'm saying because I might be talking about them, I might bust some Spanish with my friends because they do know Spanish, so talk about somebody behind their back.
Some of them don't.
Well, to me, the definition of chameleon is like a person that blended in with a lot of different cultures or really a lot of people, because you can call me a comedian because I hang with black people, white people, Asian people, Chinese people, Asian people, Iraqs, you know, all of the love. Nah, it's not really. I hang with all types of people, so it don't matter to me.
I think chameleons are kind of like hypocrites and traitors to our country.
Talking about like the rednecks and the preps and the gothic people and all that.
I think different cliques of the school have different ways to talk. I think the more ghetto groups speak in a more improper form of English, you know, kind of ebonics. I guess the depending on what kind of clique you're in, you can speak a different way, because that's the way your friends are. So,
absolutely not. I mean, I hang with Alan Leonard, and he kind of has his own language. Chase Herrera and Michael Tubb, you know, they just all kind of do their own thing and still hang out with them.
I didn't think so, because, like, a bunch of people hung out, like, during the lunchtime, and talking to everybody, like.
What English you talk?
People say that I talk like a Yankee. I'm from New Jersey, so I guess I've kind of been brought up that way. Yes, but I still have friends who speak in Ebonics. I'm straight out of the hood, too. So, we're all G's.
Absolutely not.
No. No, because we'd be like walking and be like, look at this pants, they're like so cool. And they'd be like,
they wouldn't understand what we're saying.
And they'd be like, what is word?
Oh, no. Because it seemed like, well, when he made it up, you know what I'm saying, just like a language for me, him, my homeboys, you know what I'm saying, can do it. Some people try to do it, they use it in the wrong way. They try to use nasty, like, man, I got a nasty score on my test or something. They don't go like that. You know?
Sign language. Yeah, I would. I mean, it's like, people talk like different all the time, so just because someone doesn't talk like I do doesn't mean that they're, like, an idiot.
Yeah, but, like, I would have a hard time understanding someone that didn't talk like I did.
Yeah, it's like, I don't speak Spanish, so I wouldn't have, like, a friend from, like, Puerto Rico or something.
Yeah.
Do they speak Spanish in Puerto Rico?
I think that's Spain.
You can't understand the words that I'm saying, and you don't speak English. And, I mean, there's different slangs here and there. But I mean, it's pretty easy to catch on to most of the time, and if you don't catch on to, then you might be a little slow, which is fine. In time, you may or may not figure out what's going on, but it's all about your own perception anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Hey man, check out this new lick, man. I figured it out.
Dude, I'm just really feeling, like, really overwhelmed, man. And just, you know, it's really, you know.
I just don't even try to really, you know, think about it, man. I just let it flow.
Dude, I'm just, like, thinking too much about this, man.
Hey, man, it's just whatever, dude. I mean, it's fine, man.
Yo, Nasty, man, where's my Nasty Cash? You've been knowing me Nasty Cash since Nasty way back, man. You ain't come up with it.
Hey, you know what? Nasty took it from me.
I see you, man. I gotta find Nasty, man.
You better find Nasty.
Oye, va, ¿qué está haciendo? Mira tu ropa, todo sucio, y mira, aquí está bien sucio.
Hold on, ese. Mira tu pelo.
Hold on, ese.
Yes, look at ahí.
Hold on, ese.
You better watch out before I put you in a headlock.
Hey, I don't think you want none of this, son.
I'll teach you a lesson you'll never forget.
Whatever.
Puerto Rico? What you wearing a Puerto Rico shirt for, boy? He said something about my mom.
He said, don't worry about it. It's all good. I ain't finna go. I gotta go to class. Time to go.
So whether you're some dude, a random guy walking past a valley girl, a country kid trying to learn Thai, or a girl from a foreign country, here at Shreve, we're all working towards a common goal. So grab a friend today and teach them how to understand.
The next video comes from our member Jolie, who's now 7 days, 6 hours, 15 minutes, 52 seconds Guitar Hero free. Now, instead of playing...
16 minutes!
Now, instead of playing Guitar Hero, she's made a video documentary on the Guitar Hero experience that we attend these weekly meetings for.
In 2005, a phenomenon took over the world one PlayStation at a time. The sensation goes by the name of Guitar Hero. I set out to identify 4 questions that I've been pondering over.
Well, when you first play it, like, you want to beat the song, and you just keep playing until you finally beat it.
I'd have to say the challenge.
It's pretty much awesome. I don't know. I play it all the time, so.
A lot of great songs.
Yeah, the songs sound tight, and it's like, it feels cool to act like a rock star.
You're rocking.
Yeah, rocking out.
Rocking.
When you be looking at the screen and be playing, You just be in a daze and mesmerized, you know, because it's the music, yeah. The music, that would it be.
It's played with a guitar controller. The controller consists of 5 fret buttons, a strum bar, and a whammy bar. While playing, you must learn how to use all of these functions at the same time.
What makes Guitar Hero so addicting is
everything. You get to like the whammy. You get to like move it up and down. Oh, that's amazing.
You get to actually be in the band and play a song as if you actually knew how to play guitar.
What makes Guitar Hero so addicting is that you just want to keep playing it with your friends, and it's just really fun.
And when you get good enough, there's a star power function that can be activated by rocking out or just simply pushing the select button. Your difficulty depends basically on how much time you spend playing the game. For beginners, you have easy.
Can't get past it.
For moderate players, you have medium.
I can't play hard.
For advanced players, you have
expert.
He's lying. Well, we've beaten the whole game on hard, like half of it on expert, but there's still room for improvement.
Just gotta rock.
And for all the superstars out there, you have
expert, babe. I'm the best.
I'm not very good at it. Runs about medium, and maybe medium.
Easy.
Occasionally expert when I feel like getting myself embarrassed.
I be playing on easy, cool. I ain't cold like everybody else, know what I'm saying? Yeah.
I play on super expert, master expert, you know, expert. I am the expert.
But remember, just because you know how to play a real guitar does not mean you'll be great at Guitar Hero.
Texas Flood by Stevie Ray Vaughan. That's, you know, it's good guitar solo, and intro is outstanding. You know, it's pretty good.
Message in the bottle.
Well, it depends. If you want Guitar Hero 1, it's definitely stellar. And then on Guitar Hero 2, Psychobilly Freakout. Definitely Psychobilly Freakout.
My favorite song is Psychobilly Freakout from Guitar Hero 2.
My favorite song is Sweet Child of Mine. I can beat it on hard. Not quite on expert, but I'm getting there.
I like Sweet Child of Mine also.
Fat Lip, that's song 41.
Yeah, that's my favorite.
I don't really be listening to that music. No, I just be playing. Yeah.
To get started, you must select a song in which you want to play. With soundtracks full of songs from classic rock, for example, Smoke on the Water, to modern rock, like Beast and the Harlot, it's a game that is appreciated by all generations.
Don't Stop Believing.
Yeah, I agree. That's a good one.
They need to put Thunderstruck by AC/DC on Guitar Hero.
X's and O's by Treyu.
Either Wish You Were Here by Pink Floyd or Stairway to Heaven by Led Zeppelin.
That's difficult. I think any song is good on Guitar Hero, so I don't have a favorite one to put on Guitar Hero. I don't know.
They have a lot of really good songs already, so I like all the songs that are already on there.
Give me Queen, Bohemian Rhapsody.
The Whisper song by Yin Yang Twins, because that's my favorite song, and y'all know what time it is, yeah.
It is rumored that there will be a third installment of Guitar Hero. In this rumor, it is said that the game will be released in the year 2008 on PlayStation 2 as well as Xbox 360.
So, what exactly is Guitar Hero again?
I'm going to slow down and pull back on those reins, Jesse James.
Lil Wayne's the city's angel.
What's up?
We live in America.
Louisiana.
God.
Love.
Peace.
Trust.
Believe it.
Respect. It's real.
Forget about it.